Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. For those of you that don't know me, my name is Sofia, and I upload videos on this channel twice a week on Tuesdays and Fridays about minimalism and organization. This week's video is about 50 things that you should get rid of before 2019. Let's get right into it. Item number one are cables, headphones, or power cords that you have lying around the house or in drawers. Number two is books you don't like. I really do like having books. Some people that are into minimalism prefer having them on a Kindle. If you have any book lying around that you've read and you didn't like, make sure that it gets a new home. Number three is notebooks. Now, I love notebooks. It's really hard to get rid of notebooks. I'm not saying notebooks that actually have things that you love written in them. I'm saying those notebooks that you once bought because they were pretty and you're never gonna use them again. Number four is papers and receipts. Something that really worked for me was I actually bought a photo album, and every time I bought something, I just put that receipt or that instruction manual in one of the photo album covers. It's so much easier for me to keep receipts and for me to look through them. Number five are memory cards and USB sticks. Just make sure that you look through them, keep the files you want, and when you're done with that, just recycle the USB sticks. Same thing with memory cards. Number six is lost files. Now, what I mean by this is get rid of the fact that you might lose these files before 2019. Take your laptop, take any devices that you have things that you care about on, and make sure you back them up today. If you're not very into physical backing up like me, just get a subscription for something like iCloud. This way, I don't even have to think about it. Number seven is a messy laptop desktop. Now, I know this sounds kind of weird because it's not physical objects, but having a cluttered desktop on your laptop can make or break your work. Number eight is last month's photos. I know that we all have photo rolls with hundreds of thousands of pictures in them. I also know it can be very daunting to go through all your pictures and delete them. So what I'm suggesting is just go through last month's photos. If you enjoy doing that, then just make yourself a little checklist with all of the months in the year and slowly make your way back every day so that it's not a daunting task. Number nine is Spotify or Apple Music. Go through your playlist, see if you're still listening to all of them, get rid of the ones you are not, and make yourself a new playlist for fall 2018. Number 10 is shows. I have a lot of shows that I start and I never end up wanting to finish. What I do is I use this app called TV Showtime. I keep track of all my shows there. It lets me know when a new episode is released, which is also great. If you want, you can also go through your Netflix, for example. Number 11 is pencils, pens, etc. that either no longer work or that you no longer like. You really don't need 10 black pens. Number 12 is actually random, but it's shelf surface clutter. Go through your office, look at any shelves or surfaces you may have, and see if there's anything on them that you could get rid of. Now we're moving into the bedroom. Number 13 are old or extra blankets or sheets, pillowcases, etc. I only really wash my sheets once a week. They get washed immediately and dried immediately, so technically I could even go wash them and put them back on my bed. So I only really have two. Make sure you get rid of the ones that are either old or have holes in them you don't want anymore, and just keep the ones you're genuinely still using. Number 14 are extra pillows. I used to have four pillows on my bed and now I only have two, one for me, one for my boyfriend. That's all we really need. The next item is old photos that don't make you happy. If you have picture frames around the house, look at them and see if the pictures that are in it are still making you happy. I have Polaroids on my fridge, for example, and I sometimes like to switch them out. Number 16 is what I like to call under the bed nastiness. Take some time to actually pick up your bed or move it aside and clean the bottom of your bed. It'll take some time and I know it's gonna be daunting, but it'll be worth it. Next item is top of wardrobe clutter. Now, kind of like the shelves clutter, this is the same idea, but on top of your wardrobe. Just make sure that there's nothing on top of your wardrobe that you don't want actually there. This next one is old hangers. So either look at your hangers and get rid of some or replace the ones that are broken. This next item is old magazines. I personally don't buy magazines anymore, but I know that there are some people that still do. Go through magazines and be honest with yourself. Are you ever going to read this again? Next are extra remotes. I personally only have one remote for my television, but I know that it's easy to end up with a lot of remotes. So just go through your remotes and make sure that the ones you have are ones that you still are using. Next up is living room surface clutter. Look at your coffee table, look at any side tables you may have, and see if there's anything you could get rid of. Next item is back of TV grossness. The TV is also another one that tends to accumulate a bunch of gross stuff on the back. You're halfway there, so this next item is extra or ruined pillows that you might have in your living room. My puppy tends to destroy a lot of my pillows. donate them or just see what else you can do with them. Maybe you can put a new cover on them, something like that. Just make sure you don't have pillows around that you don't actually like. So next up, we're going into the bathroom. Now, the first thing that I'm going to suggest you declutter is makeup. A lot of us like to keep little samples of makeup or makeup that we used to wear. If it's expired or you haven't used it in more than a year, get rid of it. This next one is hotel toiletries. I know I was guilty before of going into hotels and bringing back some shampoo bottles or conditioners. The reality is that I never ended up using them and now they're stacked in a drawer. Get those reusable squishy bottles and put your own shampoo and conditioner in them anytime that you go travel. This next one is hair accessories or brushes. Make sure that you look through your hair brushes and toss out any that you're not using. If you only have one, make sure you give it a good clean. Any hair accessories like hair ties, bobby pins, clips that are broken or you're no longer gonna use, either donate them or get rid of them. Old bath towels are another one that you really should be getting rid of. We only have one towel each, so we each have a hand towel and a bath towel, and that's all we really need. When we do the washing, we'll just throw them in the washer and the dryer and then bring them back in the same day, so we don't really need extras. I do have one extra towel in case I ever have visitors. My dog has one as well for his bath, but that's a different story. This next one is any old retainers. Now, I just found my retainer from when I was a teenager and I really am never gonna use that again. I've been holding on to it because I thought it was expensive and maybe one day I'll start using it again, but the reality is I really am not. This next one is tampons. Listen to me, girls. I've been using the Diva Cup for 2 years now and it's absolutely life-changing. Not only do you stop having to buy any sort of tampons, which are really expensive and very, very wasteful, but you also have a more comfortable option that you can leave in up to 12 hours. It's super easy to clean and once it's inside, you can't even feel it. The one I use is called Organica. Comes in a little cloth bag, recyclable carton paper that you can just recycle after you're done using, and it really is amazing, so I do recommend you try that out. Next are products that you no longer use or are expired. This is any hairsprays, shampoos, conditioners, face creams. Next is expired meds. I know not all of them keep our meds in the bathroom. Personally, I don't, but I just thought I'd fit them into this category. Look through your meds and see if they're no longer good. Didn't get rid of them. Maybe try asking your local pharmacy what you could do to those expired meds, but just make sure you get rid of them. Next is loofahs that you've had for too long. We should all be switching those very, very regularly. It's really up to you, but make sure you're switching those out regularly and you get rid of the one that's just been sitting in your shower for way too long. Now we're moving on into the kitchen. Next up is what I'm gonna call fridge nastiness. Now, I know that we should all be cleaning out our fridges really often. I honestly kind of only do that like once every 2 weeks and the nastiness accumulates, so now is the time. Take some time and go clean your fridge. Next is canned food that you'll never eat. I recently just bought this canned pea soup that I thought I was going to eat and I just don't really want to. So I'm just gonna put it aside and donate it because it's canned, so you can do that. Next up is your freezer. Just make sure to take some time to look through it and see if there's anything in there that you need to throw out. Next is cutlery drawers. I personally fall into this bad habit of ending up accumulating all these chopsticks and straws and all of these random things in my cutlery drawer, so I'm just gonna go through mine and I encourage you to do the same and see if there's anything that you could get rid of in there. Next are spices. I personally only have spices that I use, which are about 4 or 5. So just make sure you look through the spices you have and get rid of anything that you don't really need. This next category is about clothes and accessories. So first up is clothes that don't belong in this season. Either put them in a bag under your bed or donate it if you're not gonna use it next season. But just make sure that it's not in the closet where your clothes that you're currently using are. Next are three pieces that you haven't worn in a year. Just three items. Donate them, get rid of them, it'll make you feel so much better, and maybe it'll even encourage you to get rid of more. Next up are shoes. Look through them, take any that you don't use anymore, and donate them. Next is underwear with holes, and accompanying this is also socks that don't have a match. Next is any extra pair of gloves or mittens, or anyone that you don't know where the pair is. I personally only need one pair, and then I have one pair for my boyfriend, and that's all you need. In that same category, I'm also gonna add scarves, so just go through your scarves and see, are you really using all of them? Do you really need all of them? If the answer is no, maybe it's time you donate some of them. Next is that one bag you know you'll never use again. Next up are mismatched earrings. You don't really need earrings that you're never gonna use again because you've lost their partner. Next is any necklace that you know you're never gonna wear again. Next up are any freebies with no meaning, and that could be caps, that could be t-shirts. How many t-shirts do you really need? Get rid of those, guys. Be real with yourselves. Next is that dress you'll never wear again. Maybe it's your high school prom dress and you know you're never gonna wear it again. Last but not least, number 50 is this little bonus that I included for any of you pet lovers out there. I have a dog. Go through your pet's stuff. I personally have a box with his things that have like towels and blankets and treats. See if any of the toys are just been too used. Actually toss it out if you know your pet is not gonna use it anymore. All right guys, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video on 50 things you can get rid of before 2019. If you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up and encourage me to keep creating content. If you sticked it out this far, leave a comment down below saying what you're most excited to declutter before 2019. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you know every time I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you on my next video. Bye!